Big-time differences, big-time feuds, and big-time title matches at Spring Stampede 1 week from tomorrow night. And, of course, one of the big-time matches will be for the United States Heavyweight Championship. And I say big-time because you're not going to find any two better competitors or athletes than Chris Benoit and Dean Malenko. Going to see Dean Malenko in a few seconds make his way to the ring. Here's his opponent for this matchup, Scotty Riggs.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you what, this is going to be a good matchup here on Saturday night. What a match we got here with Malenko and Scotty Riggs. Hey, but let me tell you something else, though, too, with the Benoit Malenko thing. And we talked about this, Tony. Benoit has been in a violent confrontation with the Taskmaster, Kevin Sullivan. He has been beat up. He's been hospitalized. He's been drugged through the bathroom floors of this country. Is he ready now to go ahead and set his sights on becoming champion? I'm telling you, Spring Stampede might hold the key to where he goes from here, either up or down. You know what I'm saying?
We await the arrival.
That makes sense?
Yes, it does. We await the arrival of the United States heavyweight champion, Dean Malenko, a man who, as we saw in the control center, made an unexpected appearance during Chris Benoit's matchup, the one, as you saw earlier, Ric Flair got involved in. And at the end of the, when the match was over, why did Dean Malenko hit the ring? Is the question. Is he trying to attack Benoit? Was he trying to reason with Benoit, get to him? We don't know, but we know that he and Benoit are going to give it their all coming up next Sunday for the United States heavyweight title. There's your belt. And here we go on WCW Saturday night.
Such a workmanlike competitor as Dean Malenko. Expressions hardly ever change until lately. We have seen a more fired up, a more aggressive, a more break the rules, if you will, Dean Malenko than in the past. And out there now with Scotty Riggs, who is one of the top competitors here at WCW. Here we are on the mothership. Here it is on Saturday night, and we're just rocking and rolling along. Tony, baseball season right on the Spring Stampede. And Monday Nitro coming live, what will it hold for the wrestling fan around this country?
Well, it's always full of surprises, unexpected occurrences, I know. Some of the greatest wrestling acts in the world, and we enjoy bringing you the event coming up this coming Monday live. There's a drop on the arm by Scotty Riggs, tying up the arm here of Dean Malenko. I want to bring up something, Dream. This past Monday on Nitro, when we brought to you the program live from Duluth, Minnesota, there was an interview conducted, a little fly-in type interview from six of the NWO. And it was directed towards Eddie Guerrero. And it doesn't take a man with a small IQ to realize.
Don't look over here at me.
I didn't mean that.
I mean, you look right at me, man.
I was talking to you.
Oh, okay.
It doesn't take a man with a small IQ to realize that Six was sending a message to Eddie Guerrero. Almost as if Eddie, and I shouldn't say this, has become a part of the NWO. Now, I don't really believe that. But Six,
you know what?
Six made it out to be like that.
You know what? How many times in the past few months have you said, I don't want to believe that he's going to be a member of the NWO. I believe that he's a member of the NWO. Man, I'm going to tell you what, Tony. Them guys, I'm talking to NWO and Eric Bischoff, now knowing that he can't control WCW, they got ways of making things happen and causing rumors, if you will. But sometimes, you're right, rumors come to pass as truth. And maybe, I would hate to say it myself, but maybe Eddie Guerrero is a member of the NWO.
We know he suffered. We heard he suffered an injury after his match with Malenko at Uncensored. We have not seen him in action since that time. I don't know if that's because of the injury or because something's up with Eddie Guerrero. But very mysterious, very unsettling comments directed towards Eddie Guerrero by Six this past Monday. For Dean Malenko, though, he has to go right straight ahead, put that loss to the cruiserweight of the cruiserweight belt behind him with Six and go on and defend that U.S. heavyweight title. But hearing Malenko talk, he doesn't do that.
No, he doesn't, and I don't blame him because of the competitor that he is. And you see right now he's in a situation where, you know, Riggs has got the offense going his way. This guy's the United States heavyweight champion. This ain't the cruiserweight heavyweight champion. That's a great title, great belt. This is the United States heavyweight champion. This is big. But you said that, and I'll say that. He wants them both. He believes that the cruiserweight title was stolen from him. You know what I'm talking about? So
he's talking more about the man than he is the belt.
Yeah, exactly. Sure. That's what I'm saying. Well, answer me then. I sit over there yawning and everything, you know.
drops Scotty Riggs, kicks him on the side of the knee, and drives the knee into the side of the knee as well. Dean Malenko is awesome. He is Mr. Offense. We say the man of 1,000 holes, and of course, literally probably more than 1,000 that he can execute, that he can win a match with, that he can get you to submit, or he can turn into a 1-2-3 pin. Malenko's got Scotty Riggs tied up, and he is focusing on the leg now of his opponent.
Yeah, and not in a hurry, and that's important for everybody to understand out there. Malenko don't get in a hurry. I've seen him lately do things that were uncharacteristic for him, of the aggressive and breaking his plane of thought facial-wise, where you really seen some emotion. As long as he stays with that face just steady on what he's doing and go about his work like he's doing here, he is very hard to beat. Tremendous competitor. But Scotty Riggs knows what's at stake here, too.
Certainly does, and I wonder if Scotty Riggs will be able to stand after this one. Malenko, of course, his primary move, his number one weapon is that standing reverse figure four, or the Texas cloverleaf, as he calls it. And obviously, after all this pressure's been put on that knee, it won't take long once the cloverleaf's on to give him the win. Strategically setting it up so he can come away with the win. That's what Dean Malenko's all about, winning and losing.
Yeah,
Dean Malenko.
Yeah, and that's true. And now we turn our attention, because I know it's coming up to winning and losing. Is Dallas more involved than just beating somebody up, or is he really thinking about winning or losing? And we'll talk about that, you know, still tonight. But, man, that's right around the corner, Spring Stampede. This big pay-per-view event from Tupelo, Mississippi. Anytime WCW throw a pay-per-view out there, Tony, it's big time.
Or a Nitro.
Oh, a Nitro just running on fire.
Think of the towns we have coming up here in the springtime. We have Philadelphia. We have
Boston.
Boston coming up in the month of June.
Yeah.
So it's going to be great. And Ronald, this coming Monday.
Yeah.
Then very soon back in Nashville, Tennessee for Nitro.
I'm looking forward to that Boston thing. I guarantee you, one of my favorite cities all time, home of my favorite basketball team. I had the opportunity, to walk the hardwood floor there with Larry before it was tore down, and we looked over in the back to see where they're building the new Fleet Center right there before I retired. What a great building that is there, and the tradition around just that block that it's in, the old garden there, the Boston Celtics, Larry and me and Robert Parrish and me and... Jones and me. And,
yeah, how about that 1997 version, huh?
Well, you know, we're having a little hard. Anyway, let's go back to the match.
Moving out of the way.
Here's
Dean Malenko. And a whip into the corner.
Missed him.
Riggs shot his quick.
Roll up.
Rolled him up. 1-2. Got a two count. Ducking. Backslide. Good maneuver. Malenko down. 1-2. Malenko barely gets out of that one.
Well, you got to be just right to bridge somebody up in the backside to beat him. I guarantee you. It's a good hold if you got him in the right situation with all their weight down on the neck. Right there ain't very good. That's no good. He missed there.
And hit the back of his head as well.
Sure he did. Uh-oh.
Here he goes. See, boy, he was setting him up. Small
package.
One,
he got
two.
Him. All right.
That was a great counter move by Riggs that time.
Well, Riggs is there for the fight.
Blocked it. Shovels the right hand to the jaw. And again, this one to the side of the head to the temple. There's a reversal. Holding firmly in the center of the ring. Malenko scooting underneath. And boy, was that a great defensive maneuver.
There you go, Oklahoma
Rolls
Roll.
Rolls through with Oklahoma Roll. 1-2, and beating.
Yeah, nice move. Good offensive move. Good fight, Joe. Scotty Riggs, go ahead and hold your head up. You were in it, brother. You were in it.
Dean Malenko with the Oklahoma Roll gets the pin on Scotty Riggs and awaits Chris Benoit next Sunday.
Yes, sir, right there. Made famous by the great Danny Hodge from Oklahoma. Hooks him up right there, gets a 1-2-3.
And now we take you back to the locker room and Lee Marshall.
Well, guys, thank you very much. Here in the locker room, I'm going to get a chance to do something I know wrestling fans all around the world would like to do, and that's talk to this man. He just successfully defended the United States heavyweight title, the man of 1,000 holds, Dean Malenko. And Dean, we've hit a point in time now where I can't think about you without thinking about two guys in particular. And they are Six and Eddie Guerrero. They both really painted a bullseye on your chest, and they want this strap.
Lee, I had the opportunity after Uncensored to sit back and reflect what the total picture is all about. It doesn't take an Einstein to figure out whichever way you structure the numbers 2 and 2, you'll always get the number 4. Now, Eddie, it seems wherever you're at, Somewhere lurking back in the shadows is six. Six seems wherever you're at, somewhere nearby is Mr. Guerrero. I am no fool, gentlemen. You can fool some of the people, some of the time, but this man right here, you will never fool. Six, what you see is a U.S. belt. Now, you have something that you stole from me and that I want back, and I will not stop till I get it back around my waist, and that's that cruiserweight belt. And Eddie, I'm gonna expose you for what you really are and what you're really about, and I'm not gonna stop right there.
All right, hold on a second. We can talk about Guerrero and Six, and that's fine, but everybody knows come Tupelo, Mississippi, that spring stampede coming up. It's you defending this title against the man they now call the Wolverine, Chris Benoit.
When I think of all the great wrestlers out there in our sport, I can only think of one gentleman that mirrors the likeness of Dean Malenko. Someone who has the heart, the determination, the desire and want to be number one in this great sport. And I'm talking about you, Mr. Benoit. Now, we went toe-to-toe and head-to-head on several occasions. And if I can remember, the last time we stepped in the ring together, we went for over 30 minutes in a war. I haven't forgotten that. I talk a lot about the word respect. I respect you. I like what you're about. You take pride in what you do. That excites me. And come spring stampede, I'm going to give you an opportunity again to show me what you're about. I expect no less than 110% from you that night. Chris, I know you're not going to let me down. This right here is for your taking. Give it your best shot.
That promises to be one for the ages, Malenko and Benoit. We've got action continuing right here on TBS on Saturday night.